Today, we're going to talk about a critical component in the vehicle's engine, the drive belt, or serpentine belt. Most importantly, its crucial role in the charging and electrical systems of the vehicle. It's usually a long, flat, or V-shaped belt made of rubber and reinforced with fibers like nylon or steel. In the charging system, the drive belt connects the crankshaft of the engine to the alternator. The alternator generates electrical power to charge the battery and power the electrical system when the engine is running. The serpentine belt drives the alternator pulley, which rotates the alternator shaft, generating electricity. Without the drive belt, the alternator wouldn't be able to function properly. If the vehicle's belt is worn or loose, the alternator may not spin at the correct speed, leading to insufficient charging of the battery and electrical system failure. When you turn the ignition key, the starter motor uses electrical energy from the battery to crank the engine and start the combustion process. Once again, the drive belt is essential here. Without it, the starter motor wouldn't be able to engage the engine, leaving the customer stranded with a car that just won't start. A worn or damaged serpentine belt can lead to other issues that could indirectly impact the starter, such as a weak battery due to inadequate charging from the alternator. So, as you can see, the drive belt is a small but mighty component in the vehicle's engine. It ensures that both the charging and starting systems operate smoothly, keeping the customer's car running reliably. When discussing the signs of wear and tear with your customer, it's essential to remind them to inspect their drive belt regularly. Common signs of serpentine belt wear include squealing noises, especially during startup or acceleration, visible cracks or fraying on the belt, and a dashboard warning light indicating a charging system problem. A belt that's excessively loose or tight can also cause issues. If there are any cracks, fraying, or squealing noises, it's time to replace it to avoid potential breakdowns. When educating the customer on replacing the serpentine belt, have them first locate the belt routing diagram under the hood or in the owner's manual. Then, using a belt tensioner tool or wrench, rotate the tensioner pulley to release tension on the belt, allowing you to remove it. Install the new belt following the correct routing diagram. Once the new belt is installed, use the tensioner tool to apply the correct tension to the belt. The belt should have a slight amount of give when pressed with a finger. If it's too loose, it can slip. Too tight, and it can damage the pulleys and bearings. Educating customers on installation can increase satisfaction and prevent an unnecessary comeback. Thanks for watching.